So for this video, we are going to be talking about the 16 Tadasana cues that we went over. So essentially, Tadasana is standing up straight. And when a lot of people start yoga, they don't realize that that actually takes a lot of work. You're activating a lot of muscles. So Tadasana in and of itself is a pose, but also Tadasana cues are 16 cues that usually come in pairs, so 8 pairs. And throughout class, the teacher will signify this to tell you anatomically what to do in your body, how you should be moving things, and how you should feel. But funny enough, nobody ever teaches you these cues. So that's what we're going to go through today. Your feet can be together, or they can be hips width, whatever is more comfortable for you. Okay, so step one, ground all four corners of your feet into the mat. This can also apply to hands when you're in things like plank or downward dog. And essentially what that means, it's a little bit easier to pose with those 2 feet on the floor, but poses where there might only be 1 foot on the floor, a lot of times people go up like this, they go in like this, they might stand back, they might stand forward. The best way to do this is to kind of lift up your toes and feel the balls of your feet in the front and the back, all four corners really pushing you down, and then gently rest your toes down. And its pair, the next step, is to pull up through your inner arches. So essentially those two work together to activate the legs. You're pressing down, you're pulling up through your inner arches, which kind of activates that inner part of your leg. The next one, and I'll say the most confusing one, is rolling your shins to the midline. So the midline means towards the middle of your body instead of out. And essentially, again, what that does is it just turns on the leg. So we're grounding down, we're pulling up through our inner arches, we're making sure that our shins are facing straight forward, not out too much, not in too much. And then our fourth one is broadening through the back of the knees. So again, that is just another step to turn on your legs. And essentially making sure that we're straight forward with our legs and not having our knees go out or our knees go in. You can't really do one without the other, so it should all make sense. Then we've got rolling our inner thighs back. And then we're done with legs. So all four feet, all four corners of your feet into the ground. Pull up through your inner arches. Roll your shin bones to the midline. Broaden the backs of your knees. Roll your inner thighs back. Bottom of your body is ready to go. Next, and this is going to be really, really important, anywhere where we need to activate our core, any core work we're doing, any pose, we don't want to hurt our back. Pull up through the pelvic floor. So essentially, raise your knot against that. And you'll feel immediately that lift within your core, which is then paired with cinching the waist. So you'll hear teachers say, cinch the waist, belly button core, activate your waist, turn on your core. Essentially, the best way to think about that is just find your abs. Find whatever you've got. Another good way to think about that is belly button. Feel like it's pushing towards your spine. So we pull up through our pelvic floor, we're cinching our waist, and then we're elongating through our side bodies. So we just want to make sure, again, we're growing as tall as we can. Now, what typically happens when we lengthen the side bodies is we hunch up like this. You never want to be like that in yoga. So then, once we've elongated, we need to take our inner and outer shoulders back. Well, now that we've done that, we've kind of jutted ourselves out a little bit. So we take our shoulder blades down and onto our ribs. Well, that kind of poked our ribs out. So then we need to tuck in our ribs. And then to straighten out that whole process, broaden through the collarbone. So let's kind of walk through just that little process. Pull up through the pelvic floor, cinch your waist, lengthen your side bodies, take your shoulders back, take them down, take them forward, put your arms in the perfect place, make sure your ribs aren't jutting out, and shine through those collarbones like they're smiling. Then what we want to do, just to really get length, we've done so much from the ground up, is take our neck, just kind of backing up. Really what that means is don't be slumping in your neck, okay? And then broaden through the top of your head. So a lot of times you want that to feel like someone had a string going from your head to the ceiling. They just kind of tucked in. Energize your fingertips, jazz hands, and smile. So a lot of times in yoga, people get this look on their face of like pure anger, maybe constipation, not breathing. So a lot of times to get you out of that moment of concentration, teachers will say that. So I'm gonna run through all of those together quickly without breaking them down too much. And if you have any questions, just ask me in class. Tadasana. Ground down through all four corners of your feet. Pull up through your inner arches. Roll your shins to midline. Broaden through the backs of your knees. Roll your inner thighs back. Pull your pelvic floor up. Cinch the waist. Lengthen the side bodies. Shoulders back. Shoulders down. Onto the ribs. Arms down. Tuck in your ribs. Broaden through that collarbone. Lengthen the neck. Pull up through your head. Jazz hands. And smile. Now, directionally, like I said, the last thing that I want to mention to you guys is ground through all four corners of your feet. Also applies to ground through all four corners of your hands. We'll go through that when we look at down dog and plank. And rolling your inner thighs back, that can also mean up. So when you're standing, that would be back. But when you are, say, in a plank or a downward facing dog, that same action is to roll them up to the ceiling. So pending where your body is, the teacher might say a little differently. I hope that's helpful. See you soon.